Tell me, can you feel my heartbeat? Tell me, as I kneel down at your feet. I knew there would come a time when these two hearts would entwine. Just put your hand in mine forever. For so long, I have been an island where no one could ever reach these shores. We've got a whole lifetime to share, and I'll always be there. Darling, this I swear.
So please believe me. For these words I say are true. And don't deny me.
Step closer. afternoon, everyone, and let me welcome you here today on behalf of the management and staff of the Sandals Grand St. Lucia and the management and staff of the St. Lucia Tourist Board. Today is a very memorable and special day for you, Christopher and Brittany, and I wish you every happiness and a joyous married life. The fact that your marriage is taking place at this hotel as opposed to the church takes nothing away from the dignity, legality, and seriousness of the institution of marriage. This is a civil ceremony, but that does not mean it is not a blessed occasion. And to make you feel more comfortable and less nervous, I'll refer to you by your first names only. And may God bless you, Christopher and Brittany, on this day and always. We now come to the rite of marriage, and I'm going to be asking the couple a few questions, and I would like them to answer me in the positive. And if Christopher says no, then we'll call the whole thing off. Christopher and Brittany, have both of you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes.
Christopher and Brittany, do you intend to love, respect, and cherish each other as long as you both shall live?
Yes.
And finally, do you solemnly declare that there is no legal impediment to this marriage? I'm now going to read a short passage from the Bible, and it's all about love. It says, love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in others' wrongdoings, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. True love never comes to an end. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three. And the greatest of these is love. And that's from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4 to verse 8, and verse 13. I, Christopher. Do take you, Brittany. To be my lawfully wedded wife. And I promise. To be true to you. In good times and bad times. In sickness and in health. To laugh with you in joy. To grieve with you in sorrow. To grow with you in love. And to have and to hold. In all circumstances. For richer or poorer. Better or worse. From this day forward. Forsaking all others. Till death do us part. Brittany. Do take you, Christopher. To be my lawfully wedded husband. And I promise. To be true to you. In good times and bad times. In sickness and in health. To laugh with you in joy. To grieve with you in sorrow. To grow with you in love. And to have and to hold. In all circumstances. For richer or poorer. Better or worse. From this day forward. Forsaking all others. Till death do us part. Thank you.
Brittany, I vow to give you all of my heart. I vow to be the best husband I can be. I vow to hold your hand forever and I vow to go with you anywhere. I vow to stand beside you, not in front of or behind. I vow to learn from you and to learn with you. I vow to respect you and I vow to take care of you forever. I vow to love your family as I do my own. I vow to keep things interesting. I vow to love your singing. And I vow to love you. And last but not least, I vow to marry you today and stay married to you forever.
Christopher, today is just another ordinary day, but for me, today is the day you're making all my dreams come true. Today I stand here and vow to you that I will be a loving and devoted wife. I vow to always have patience, be slow to anger, and quick to forgive. I vow to be your guiding light when you feel lost, your comfort when you are unsure, and the crying shoulder when your Cowboys lose on Sunday. I vow to stand by you through good times and bad, laughter and tears, and through the sunshine and the rain. I vow to make your life as happy as you have always made mine and never take advantage of the amazing person that you are. In you, I have found my best friend, true love, and my soulmate. I vow to never lose sight of our love, and most importantly, I vow to spend the rest of my life by your side.
If you look at these rings, you see that they are significant in your marriage, in that they are a symbol of your marriage and will indicate that you're married. They signify eternity and will remind you of the vows you've taken here today. If you look at these rings, you see they form a circumference and are continuous in that one end meets the other and therefore never ending. And they're also of a solid metal, and this should indicate to you that your marriage should be everlasting and built on a solid foundation. And may the good Lord bless these rings and you who wear them. And may you always live together in peace, love, and harmony. Brittany,
take this ring.
As a sign of my love.
Devotion.
And fidelity to you.
Got it.
Now you take it. Make sure he gives you the right hand,
huh?
Left hand. Just kidding. This one.
Repeat after me, Christopher.
Christopher.
Take this ring.
As a sign of my love.
Devotion.
And fidelity to you.
Now that you've taken vows and exchanged rings, there's a spiritual commitment and a covenant between you. The success of your marriage depends on what you put into it. You must exercise patience, kindness, trust and loyalty, and finally, always be the best friend of each other. And now by virtue of the powers of the laws of St. Lucia, vested in me as a civil status marriage officer, I now declare Christopher and Brittany to be husband and wife. Congratulations, you may kiss your bride.
Forever can never be long enough for me to feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one.
Christopher and Brittany, you have just sealed your relationship by the giving and receiving of rings and the exchange of a kiss. And this covenant is a relationship pledge between two people who agree that they will commit themselves to one another throughout their lives. The most beautiful example of this partnership is the marriage relationship. You have committed here today to start the rest of your life with each other. Today this relationship is symbolized through the pouring of these two individual containers of sand. One representing you, Christopher, and all that you were, and all that you are, and all that you ever will be. And the other representing you, Brittany, and all that you were, and all that you are, and all that you ever will be. As these two containers of sand are poured into the third container, the individual containers of sand will no longer exist, but will be joined together as one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into the individual containers, so will your married be. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my high honor and privilege to present to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Christopher and Brittany Hubel.
Hands out to the sky, we dance with monsters through the night. Whoa, oh. There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions in my heart, like why are we here and where do we go, and knock on us so hard. It's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Them stars and we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. Just might find their way into my dreams tonight, but I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do, but if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between. With only two, just me and you, not so many things we got to do. What places we got to be, we'll sit beneath the mango tree now. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. When your legs don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you off of your feet, will your mouth still remember?